It's people like little Kenny Hutton from Carshalton who've benefited from transplants. He was born with a kidney problem. Now, after a recent transplant, he's discovered the joys of certain foods denied to him over the years because of his complaint.
Cheese.
Cheese? You're into big cheese sandwiches, are you? He and others with kidney problems were out today at Waterloo Station campaigning for more people to carry donor cards and give to research. Donors dropped dramatically 5 years ago when there were claims that organs were being taken from people clinically still alive. Now the number's back to that level. But the new furore over plans to transplant pigs' organs into humans has left the Kidney Research Fund dismayed. They feel that although it could save lives in the long run, paradoxically people could die in the meantime as a result.
I think it would be marvellous if it became a reality. But my view is that we are possibly 10 years away from such a breakthrough. And in that 10 years, there will be literally thousands and thousands of people who will die. So don't be misled by this premature publicity of what may happen in the year 2000 and on. Carry the card, support kidney research, and save a life today.
For 35-year-old Annabel Turpin from East Sheen, a transplant could mean the end of dialysis. For the last 16 years, she's had kidney problems, which have contributed to current problems with walking. Dialysis is a pain.
I hope people realise, you know, what it means to have a new kidney, because you feel so totally different. You can eat what you like, you can drink what you like, you can play games, and you feel like rushing around and doing lots of things. And it's wonderful. It's a new lease of life.
And the Kidney Research Fund hope today's Gift of Life campaign throughout Britain will result in more donors and more money for research to help people like Annabel and Kenny lead a normal life.